school, I didn't get into university anywhere, so I didn't really have any choices. I had to stay home and attended community college for 3 years and worked as a mechanic during that time. And Purdue was really the only choice that I allowed for myself because my father and uncle were both Purdue graduates, and I had a great uncle in 1905 that graduated from Purdue University as well. I also was well aware that Purdue had graduated so many astronauts. I had it in my mind that I was interested in the space program and thinking of the best way to leverage that, and so I had this scheme that if I could come and study geology and geophysics, then I might someday be involved with space exploration and mining resources on other planets. And that was my goal, that was my dream. So when I showed up at Purdue, I got into geosciences, and I liked the aspects of travel with the geology and got to see some great places in North America. Purdue was a good fit for me, and so focused on sciences and geophysics, and met my wife there after my first 2 weeks of school during the counselor training program. I actually met her on Slater Hill. First time I ever saw her was running down Slater Hill, and we've been together ever since. I raced go-karts after high school for about 5 years, and when I got to Purdue and joined up with the fraternity, I got onto the Grand Prix team and drove for 3 years with the team and was a Grand Prix chairman for two of those 3 years and had a good time. One of the reasons I did it was that my uncle won the race in 1965 and my dad drove in the race in 63, so there was sort of a family history of Grand Prix, and that was something that I wanted to do. And that was like the best thing about being there at school was springtime rolled around. The weather was perfect. We'd be out the track every day practicing. It was right. Just the best way to spend the afternoons. With a short shuttle flight, 2 weeks or so in duration, you know, you're so extremely busy. There really isn't time to think about maybe the little details or something that might be bugging you at the time, because it's, you know, in 2 weeks it's going to be over, you'll be back on the ground. With ISS it's a little different because, you know, 6 months is a long time for something to be chipping away at you and bothering you. So it's important for us to keep an open line of communication at all times. We spend a lot of time getting to know each other, sometimes in stressful or dynamic situations, just to be able to anticipate, you know, what's going to be next from somebody. And sometimes it's more about the relationships than it is even about the technical information. The technical stuff you can sort of get on the fly, but the reactions and the support and backing each other up, you know, that just comes from years of developing relationships and trust. What's happening here is an attempt to put humans in space permanently and forever, for better or for worse. This is the only place, you know, this industry, this thing that we're doing is the only place in the world, in the history of humans, where we're trying to put the human race in space. And to me, it's just incredible. I can't believe every day I just thankful that to be a part of it. I feel like I've been here a long time. I'm, you know, 17 years into being an astronaut, and it's hard not to love this job. I mean, there's no better job, I think, on the planet, except for the one off the planet.